sports car stadium outside Atlanta.
Greetings!
But there was a different game on the field that day. Sisters India and Felicia Jordan, Black Girls Grilling, were just one of 150 teams.
Amazing.
Representing at Oktoberfest.
Oh yeah, I could spend some time on this.
A friendly competition and celebration in honor of their favorite 50-year-old gastronomic gadget.
Yeah, I'm an expert.
The Big Green Egg.
I mean, it's a cooking machine. We literally go from smoking 200 pounds of smoke oxtail to a 100 pound cake. There's anything in the
cooking machine. You know, what can I cook in a Big Green Egg?
It'd be quicker to try to make something you could.
We can give it as a laboratory.
Hardy Irani is the company's CEO.
You can grill, roast, bake, smoke, sear, and just about everything in between. So what does that mean? You know, obviously it means steaks, but it also means pies.
This is my love letter to food.
This ingenuity is centuries old.
Kamado refers to a style. In India, you call it a tandoori. In Asia, you call it a kamado. And it references a oval-shaped vessel with a lid. In the early days, the vessel was made out of clay, and today the egg is ceramic.
The charcoal used in barbecue gets part of its name from the shape, but the rest is a mystery that only its 90-year-old founder, Ed Fisher, can solve.
Well, they're big and what's it look like? They look like they're married.
Yes.
And now I think of, well, green is an outrageous color. You know, who buys green things? So I said, call it the Big Green Egg.
Turns out that millions of people are seeing green.
Bacon wrap for you. Have you had one of those?
For Ed Fisher, though, there's something more.
Magic is when someone cooks on an egg and he cooks for his family, whether it's the wife or the husband, they become a hero.
So the Big Green Egg makes you a superhero.
Makes you a superhero, yes.
He wrote some of the most memorable music of the 20th century. On the centennial of his birth, Henry Mancini's magic endures. Well, we're at the second look at our appreciation from Tracy Smith.
Even if you've never been here, you probably recognize Abbey Road. There's the crosswalk, as seen in the famed Ian McMillan cover photo for a Beatles album in the fall of 69. And inside, it's much the same as it was back then. Even the piano used for Lady Madonna is still here. Some of the best-loved music of a generation was played in this room. And it still is. Last year, the Royal Philharmonic incidentals of composer Henry Mancini's classic, Blue River. As we've been reporting, the Mancini family has re-recorded some of the maestro's most famous songs in celebration of what would have been his 100th birthday.
1, 2, 3.
The record debuted last month and immediately shot to number one, and it's not hard to see why. Some pretty big names are on it, like Quincy Jones and John Williams.
Yeah.
Helped re-record and Grammy-winning Peter Gunn.
What does it feel like to play it again?
Chris, it sounds almost like it's slurring into B2, da, da, instead of ba, da.
Producer Greg Field, who also happens to be married to Monica Mancini, is leading the effort to honor his father-in-law.
I know it's kind of hard to sum up, but what do you think the world should know about Henry Mancini?
Well, nobody under 50 probably knows who Henry Mancini is, right? But they know Pink Panther.
virtually anywhere in the world and go up to a candle and just say, Ronda, and the immediate response. And I can't imagine another composer that has created music that generation to generation, decade to decade, keeps resonating with people.
Mancini music from artists you might not expect, like Elton John. And Cynthia Erivo, who was among the stars last month at an all-Mancini program at the Hollywood Bowl.
You know, we're celebrating his 100th birthday, and still it's so, the music's so alive. And we are doing everything we can to have the music be out there and have people enjoy it and have it take you someplace, have it make you feel something, which is what music should do.
No Mancini concert is complete without the Pink Panther theme here by Sax great Dave Collins. For the album, the song was re-recorded in New York City last April by none other than the legendary Sir James Galway on the flute. And he was joined by someone he inspired to pick up the flute herself.
Oh, what about the Blue Panther theme? It's there!
Lizzo. How they sound? You be the judge. The Pink Panther theme is still one of Henry Mancini's most popular tunes, and Dave Collins plays it as well as anyone ever. But it's not his favorite.
I know you've said that your favorite song is a Mancini song.
Yes. But not the one you would think. With the saxophone in my hand.
Not Pink Panther.
Not Pink Panther. Moon River.
Moon River.
It's a perfect melody. It's a perfect year.
In fact, Moon River has been called the crown jewel of Mancini's work. Johnny Mercer's lyrics about wide rivers and huckleberries are drawn from his memories of a childhood spent in Savannah, Georgia. Henry Mancini wrote the music specifically for Audrey Hepburn to sing and tailored it to fit her limited vocal range. His family says it took him a month to write the first three notes, and once he had those, it only took him a half hour to write the rest. The song quickly became a hit, and more.
May I have the envelope, please?
The song was nominated for an Academy Award for Best Song.
Oh, the winners are Henry Mancini and Johnny Mercer from Moon River.
In addition to the Oscar, the song also picked up a pair of Grammys, and the great Andy Williams made it his own. And for the latest version of Moon River, the Mancini family passed the torch to another legend.
Bublé Mancini, I was like, one. Finally, Bublé Mancini. Finally, my name is attached to the Mancini name. I have waited so long for that.
Yes. When the wind will ever start to dance
with me. You'd think that in his 30-year career, Michael Bublé would have made his own version of Moon River, but he's never recorded the song, and he jumped at the chance.
When the Mancini family calls and asks you to be part of honoring the legacy of a genius, you say, thank you so very much. I would love to be there. Can we do it in Vancouver? Because I'm in 46 countries, and I'm only going to be home for 6 days. But you say yes.
All right. Yeah. I'm good at your...
And we met him in Vancouver on the day of the session. He had limited time and a miserable cold.
I knew a couple days ago my daughter started coughing, and I went like, oh, okay. And she stayed in our bed, and I was like, this is going to happen to me. So it's going to be fun to see how I sound.
To Drifter.
In the end, the cold didn't seem to bother him or anyone else.
We're at the same way.
Mancini's music, whether it's Hepburn and a guitar, or Buble's voice and the Royal Philharmonic strings. The songs sound the way Henry Mancini would have wanted them to sound. Perfect.
See you tomorrow.
We love you. We'll see you here on the Family Field.
Show until next time. This is Peter Tomarkin on behalf of the Bukkake Rug saying thanks for pressing your luck. Bye-bye.
Anyway, we have just 10 seconds to say goodbye. We'll see you tomorrow. So long.
Bye-bye. Yeah.
We got 5 seconds.
Oh, no. We have 3, 2, 1.
Bye. Bye.